After 2 days in the Aboriginal community, I continued my way south. I made it to Fitzroy Crossing, where I was hosted by Mitch and Heather, and I discussed with them how to get to the Willer Bridge Roadhouse, as it's over 200 km.
Okay, I think the problem with the distance might be solved today, or it is probably solved. Yesterday Heather mentioned that here is a Aboriginal art center, and there are people working from the Jimbala Kadunj community. And the Jimbala Kadunj community is 110 km from Fitzroy, so exactly in the middle. And so I went in there to ask John if it's okay if I charge. He said, yeah, sure, my daughter lives there. Just ask for her name and I explain it, and I'm sure they will help you out. So, all good. I'm in the Aboriginal community, and it's pretty cool. I drove into here, and these people here, they were waving at me, like, hey, welcome here. And then I asked them, like, hey, I'm doing this and this, can you help me out? And then you said you already knew me, yeah?
Yeah, I've seen you on Facebook.
On Facebook, amazing.
Yeah.
So, that was... Yeah, too easy, and you were so nice to let me charge. So I'm charging the car at the moment. And it will take a little while, and then I can continue. So you live here, living here?
Yeah, we both live here, at Jimbala Kadunj community.
Yeah?
Yeah, it's a long name, it's hard to pronounce.
How many people live here in the community?
20 something.
About 20, yeah. Wow. Okay, and how is it to live on a so remote, like? Because you are quite far from everything, actually.
Yeah, yeah.
No, that's right. It's good.
Yeah?
Quiet.
Quiet, yeah.
Yeah, quiet, so it's good.
You enjoy that? Yeah.
Yeah.
Cool.
Good people, yeah.
Yeah?
Yeah.
So what do you do on a Saturday night? You go make a party?
Or
do you,
the cabin fishing?
Yeah.
Hunting?
Yeah?
Yeah.
What do you hunt?
Turkey.
Okay.
Get a beef if you want.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Kangaroo?
Yeah, kangaroo.
Yeah?
Yeah.
Yeah, kangaroo. I don't really like the taste of it.
Get out of it, you two.
There's a little problem with the generator. It's not stable, so my car doesn't want to charge. That happens sometimes, and I cannot charge here. So I have 55% left, and it's about 110 to the next place. Could just make it, maybe not. But yeah, I have to keep going. All right. Well, thanks for helping me out.
That's all right.
And all the best.
Have a safe trip.
Yeah, we'll have. I'm leaving the community, and I just want to say that I find it very special how many warmth and how many hospitality and kindness I was welcomed here by these people. And so far there have been so many Australians who said, like, watch out when you go to a community because they can be dangerous, you can end up with spears in your back, and they can be very dangerous people. But so far, every Aboriginal I met so far, just like these ones, are very kind and want to share stuff with you. Yeah, I'm really amazed by that. All right, I'm pretty amazed. I made it to the roadhouse. Here's the roadhouse. I did 249 km, minus a 10, so I did 239 km on one charge. And I have 1% battery left. Alright, you can focus. 1% battery left. Unbelievable, it was just on zero actually, but it when it stops it goes up. So yeah, the past 10-20 kilometers were, because I was already on below 5%, and I was not sure if I'm going to make it, but I thought if I not make it, it's so close and somebody will tell me. But I made it, and this roadhouse has a caravan park also, and so I think I'm safe if the generator is working properly at least. Last night I stayed at the campsite of the roadhouse. I paid for that $38 for a powered campsite. It is 180 km to Broome. In this map I will be showing the people who helped me get to Broome. A few months ago in Indonesia I ran into problems. Then I did a crowdfunding campaign and people donated kilometers. So everybody who donated to this, thanks a lot, because yeah, it's thanks to you I've got here and able to make this beautiful road trip through Down Under. And in the coming weeks and months I will be showing more maps of the people who contributed. You know how much I preach about sustainability. Business travel is very common nowadays and it has its effect on our planet. Please try to be more responsible and aware of the damage you are causing and go for greener methods of collaboration. Start by downloading Bliss, a new video conferencing solution by TeamViewer, a new generation of collaboration tool with a full stack of features necessary for seamless collaboration. Starting a meeting is super easy. It has HD video and audio quality. You can share your screen in 4K with more than 300 people. It is just as good as a face-to-face meeting, except Bliss lets you record your sessions and play them back later, which is quite convenient if you ask me. The link to their website is in the description below. Please download it and give it a try. It is free also. I made it to Broome. I'm at my host's house. My host is Mark. Dutch guy found out about me. He's not at home at the moment, but he said, yeah, just drop in, I leave the door open and help yourself out. Mark has also been so nice to receive a package for me, but it has somehow not been sent to his home, but is now at the post office. So he left me a letter so I can pick up that package. So I got myself a new lens. Recently I got a new partner, which is Bliss, and they're contributing some money, so, and that I want to put back into the project and want to get some stuff which will make especially my videos better in this case. So I got myself a wide angle lens, because the ones I have now are very, very narrow, and also this one is very good for star photography, and here in Australia you can see the Milky Way, it's beautiful, and I just want to take some amazing pics from and with the car and then the Milky Way on top of that. So this is the first shot with the new lens on, and see the difference. I didn't move the camera, and in the previous shot my head was touching the upper of the screen. I see how wide it is. Unbelievable. I'm really amazed by this camera. My host Mark just returned home from a long day of work.
Hi, how's it going?
Hi Mark, I'm good, how are you?
Yeah, always good, always good.
Thanks a lot for inviting me into your nice little home. And how did you end up here?
Long story short, I was in England, got sick of it, raining all the time, and I thought I want to go to Australia. So ended up in Perth, then Adelaide, and now I found a job here in Broome.
Awesome, what are you doing?
I'm a jeweler.
A jeweler?
I make jewelry, yep.
Wow.
I'm making the most sustainable meat for you.
Oh yeah?
Which is kangaroo.
Why is it sustainable?
It's more sustainable than beef anyways. Beef is not very good for the environment. And kangaroo, it gets shot in the wild by the government anyways. They are considered the best, and may as well.
Is there still not a lot of water used to make the meat? Because that's the problem with beef meat.
I'm not sure about that one. Mm. But I do know that they don't fart methane like beef does. And that way, there's lots of different ways. It has lots a lot less effect on the environment than the normal meat does.
It's my first full day here in Broome. I'm right on the beach, beautiful spot. And I'm with a woman here with a huge camera. What are you doing with this camera?
I'm filming you.
Filming you, yeah. Why did you want to interview me?
I think your story is very fascinating, and I think Australia will think your story is fascinating too.
So. Yeah.
And learning a lot about electric cars.
Yeah, yeah, that's important. Okay. And you're from which channel?
GWN,
yeah.
7 News.
And that's all around Australia?
That's all around WA.
Ah, okay, sweet, yeah. Amazing. Yeah, this morning I was on the beach with a journalist, and now I'm on the beach with a Dutch guy. I'm with Wijnand, and he just sent me a message on Facebook. He said, "Hey, Wiebe, I've been following you for a while, and I just saw your car driving in Broome. Do you have time to meet up?" So yeah, obviously. And so what brought you here, Wijnand?
Yeah, I'm backpacking around the world.
Yeah.
And I was following you, like you said, like already in... you didn't say that. I was following you already back home, and I'm backpacking from Perth up to Darwin.
Yeah.
And I saw you driving in your car today in Broome, so I thought I'd send you a message. Really cool.
Yeah, amazing. Broome was pretty good for me. Dylan and his friends took us to a nice spot for some beers. I went bodyboarding with Mark, who also gave me a lesson in flatlining, which
key.
Was not so successful yet. After a few days in town, I headed south, and my next stop was at another Aboriginal community where I was invited by the teachers. Okay, I arrived in Bidji, as they call it here. And we were the two teachers. Gary, sorry,
yeah, and Jasmine.
And Jasmine, sorry. And can you tell me a bit about? Tell me first, how did you find me? Because it's a small community.
So I'm on a teacher site on Facebook.
Yeah.
And somebody shared it onto there, and said, and I had a look, and I thought, okay, he's got to come from Kununurra to Broome and then down. And I thought, well, Bidjidanga's about 188 k's along from Broome, and there's not much else in between. So I thought, somebody here doesn't offer him somewhere to stay, it's going to be a bit difficult to get on down to Sandfire.
Yeah.
So I just said to Gary, do you mind? He's fine. So we did that, and then I told my kids about it at school.
Yeah.
They're pretty excited. They don't believe that it's possible to plug in a... They're just looking at me. They don't believe that it's possible to plug a car into electricity. So I've got to convince them of that tomorrow when they actually see the car. But they've watched a few videos on YouTube about it, so they instantly recognize Wiebe in the shop. Plus, he was the only tall white guy, so
yeah. What is this, Jasmine?
This is a crocodile trap. They're
crocodile.
Trying to get a 4-meter croc that's been lurking around down here, but it's not set at the moment, so obviously the cage is down. But when the tide comes right up, you can see how much that tide's going to come up. It's way down now, but we've got 10-meter tides here in Bidjidanga, the same as Broome and Derby.
Wow.
And this will come up, and I'll put some sort of a bait in the back there.
The Bidjidanga community is the biggest Aboriginal community in Western Australia. About 850 people live here, and they have access to internet, a supermarket, and everything else you would expect in a normal town. In the morning, I gave a presentation to various kids of the community, and they were quite enthusiastic about the idea. So what do you think about the electric car? You think it's good? Bad?
Yeah, you don't need to have money to fill up.
Yeah. Yeah, cool.
You can travel faster.
Travel faster, yeah. So you would like one?
Maybe,
yeah. Yeah, cool, guys. Well, thanks for listening today, guys.
Yeah.
That was nice.
Thank you.
All right, see you. This is the end of this video. As you probably had noticed, it took a while since the last video,
I just arrived in Perth and I am editing all the footage from along the coast. Next video will be online very soon. I've one more move running.